A concertmaster has many, many roles to play in an orchestral institution like the Philadelphia Orchestra. My main job is to lead the first violins. An orchestra of about 100 people, you have the most of any instrument is the violins. You have about 32, 33 violins. My main purpose is to lead by example, to play and to show my colleagues in the violin section perhaps the color that we want to create on our instruments, the kind of playing that we want to do, the phrasing, because many times the violins are carrying the melody, carrying the tune. It's really important that a concertmaster can transmit a lot of information through non-verbal communication. Maybe the tilt of a head, maybe expression on my face, maybe the way I move my upper body. Many people associate concertmasters who know a little bit about the orchestral world. They think, oh, concertmaster has to be ready to step in at moment's notice. At this level, with one of the great orchestras, arguably one of the greatest orchestras in the world, the Philadelphia Orchestra, really nothing is going to go so wrong that the concertmaster has to save the day. That's really not going to happen. But there may be a juncture or corner in the music where things maybe are not quite lining up, or where the conductor is paying a little bit more attention to, say, the basses over on this side. And so his kind of back is turned to us, and we might have the melody. Well, at that point, I might see that point in the music. We're not quite matching up with the woodwinds. The conductor's back is turned to us a bit, and at that point, maybe we do need a little bit of rhythmic stability. At that point, I might kind of turn my head just a little bit, just to remind people, oh, hey, heads up, everybody, heads up. It's very subtle, this kind of nonverbal communication. Some of the other main or important roles that a concertmaster has to play, the conductor is the unquestioned leader of the orchestra. He or she conducts and shows the members of the orchestra the type of interpretation that he wants of that piece, he or she wants from that piece of music. However, the concertmaster can kind of act as a, you could call it a liaison, a translator. So I will watch what the conductor is trying to transmit to the orchestra, and I will try to read the conductor's mind and transmit that to my colleagues. Again, through nonverbal communication. Also, a concertmaster has to represent the orchestra in front of the public. Conductors come in and out, they're traveling all over the world, they have many roles to fill as well. So a concertmaster, in some cases, can also be the face of the orchestra in the press, in public, social media. I can speak for the orchestra. In a nutshell, that is really the main duty of a concertmaster, and that is to represent the membership of the orchestra. So the first thing the conductor does when they come on stage for a concert is they walk on stage and they shake my hand. Now, the maestro is not shaking my hand personally only. He is symbolically shaking hands with the entire orchestra through me. And after the piece is finished and we're getting a rousing standing ovation, he'll ask the orchestra to stand. Many times there'll be just a brief moment, just a glimmer of eye contact between the two of us, kind of saying, okay, let's get him up. And so he'll go like, he doesn't have to do much, he'll just go like this, and then I'll stand up and everybody follows. When do we sit down? When I sit down. Everybody kind of looks, okay, it's time to sit down. That way everything looks kind of uniform, organized, and beautiful and elegant. What is so rewarding and amazing about all of us being a member of this great institution is that almost on a nightly basis, we have these moments where you could write about it and put it in your memoirs. And they are written about. Maybe a New York Times review will make it to the front page of the New York Times, right below the fold. Something that people all over the world will read. Why would they be interested? This is one of the most important cultural institutions in the world. We have so many wonderful performances in our history, not only here in Philadelphia, but at Carnegie Hall, in Suntory Hall in Tokyo, at the Musikverein in Vienna. Many great conductors, many wonderful soloists, and incredible repertoire.